Hello student, myself Professor Gada Keses from S&T College of Engineering and Research Center, Eula. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is the solar and wind energy. From that subject, we have started the unit number 4, and from that unit number 4, that is case study on the solar energy application, we have seen some topics up to the last lecture. Now, in the particular unit, we have to learn the 3 case studies. First case study is related to the solar food dryer. Second case study is related to the parabolic dish collector versus parabolic dish solar cooker. And third case study is related to the photovoltaic system. Now, up to the last lecture, we have covered the first 2 case studies. And in the last lecture, we have started the case study number 3. And we have seen some topics from the case study number 3. So here case study number 2 is given, but that points are related to the case study number 3, that is the photovoltaic system. So don't consider that case study number 2. So let's see which point we have discussed about the case study number 3, that is the photovoltaic system. So first point we have seen what is the photovoltaic system, and second point we have seen how the photovoltaic system will work. So that 2 points we have covered in the last lecture. Those who don't seen that video, you have to see that video first and then you have to watch this video. So next point we are going to start in the today's lecture, that is nothing but the photovoltaic system components. So components of photovoltaic system we have to discuss. So let's see how does solar system works, that all of you know. For that I have shown you one diagram. Sunlight receives on the solar panel. So solar panel will collect the sunlights and convert it into the electrical energy. So after that solar panel, there will be the inverter. That means the energy released or energy generated by the solar panel is in the form of DC current. But so many appliances are there which are not working directly on the DC current. So to operate that, we have to first convert DC current into the AC current, and for that purpose inverter is required. So after the solar panel, there will be the inverter. So from the solar panel, direct current will pass to the battery, and after the inverter, current will pass to the home appliances for use alternate current. All of you understand? So like that solar system will work. That we have also seen in the last lecture also, and in the today's lecture we are going to see. So those who have not seen the last video, you can see that video. Now the main points in the today's lecture, that is nothing but the system components, that is the photovoltaic system components. All of you know that photovoltaic system consists of number of parts, as I have shown you one figure here. Let's see that figure. So if you see that parts figure, how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 parts are there. So we have to see that all 4 parts. So let's see what they have said about system components. In addition to the solar panel, there are other important components of a photovoltaic system which are commonly referred to as the balance of the system, or BOS. What they have said? BOS. These components, which typically accounts for over half of the system cost and most of the maintenance, can include, so which are that parts, additional parts? Inverter, racking, wiring, combiner, then disconnect, then circuit breakers and electric meters. So that's are the points which are extra with the solar photovoltaic system. So let's see the first point from the solar photovoltaic system, that is nothing but the solar panel. So all of you know what is the solar panel. Solar panel is a solar collector, solar radiation collector. So they are receiving the energy from the sunlights and converting it into the electrical energy. That is nothing but the solar panel. So let's see what they have said about solar panel. Solar panel consists of mini solar cells with semiconductor properties encapsulated within a material to protect it from the environment. That means solar panel consists of number of solar cells. These properties enables the cells to capture the lights. Due to that semiconductor property, that enables the cells to capture the lights or sunlight, or more specifically the photons from the suns. That means that capability of the semiconductor materials is absorbing the photons from the semiconductor sunlights. Okay, so the photons from the sun and convert their energy into the useful electricity through a process called the photovoltaic effect. That overall process is called the photovoltaic effect. That is nothing but the solar panel. On either side of the semiconductor is a layer of conducting material which collects the electricity produced. All of you understand that? That is nothing but the solar panel. So how does solar panel will work? All of you understand? Solar panel, in the solar panel will receive the energy, and it have the cells which will receive the sun energy or photons from the sun and convert it into the useful electricity. And the energy electricity produced by the solar panel is in the form of DC current. So to use that into the home appliances, we have to convert it into the AC supply. So next point is nothing but the inverter, or next component in the solar photovoltaic system is nothing but the inverter. So let's see what is the inverter. An inverter is an electrical device that accepts the electrical current in the form of direct current and convert it to the alternating current. For solar energy system, this means the DC current from the solar array is fed through the inverter, which converts it into the AC current. This conversion is necessary to operate most electric devices or interface with the electric grid. Inverters are important for almost all solar energy systems and are typically the most expensive components after the solar panel themselves. That means after the solar panel, there is a inverter is a component which is a more expensive in the solar photovoltaic system. The solar inverter ELO mounted to the solar racking inverters DC electricity from the solar array to useful AC electricity. Most inverter have conversion efficiency of 90% or higher and contains important safety features including the ground fault circuit interface and anti-icelanding. This shut down the PV system when there is a loss of grid powers. All of you understand that? That means they have also the safety points also. So that is nothing but the above the inverter. In the simple way, we can say that inverter is a component which will convert the DC current received from the solar panel to the AC current for the home appliances circuits. Third component is nothing but the racking. So let's see what is the racking. Racking refers to the mounting apparatus which fix the solar array to the ground or rooftop. All of you understand? That means it is nothing but the mounting apparatus. Racking is nothing but mounting apparatus. So typically constructed from the steel or aluminium, this apparatus mechanically fix the solar panel in place with a high level of precision. Racking system should be designed to withstand extreme weather events such as hurricanes and tornado levels, wind speed, and or have high weather events or have high accumulations of the snow. Another important features of the racking system is to electrically bond and ground the solar array to prevent the electrocution. Rooftop racking systems typically comes in the variation including flat roof systems and pitch roof system. For the flat roof, it is common for the racking system to include the weighted ballast to hold the array to the roof using the gravity. On pitch rooftop, the racking system must be mechanically anchored to the roof structure. All of you understand? That means what? In the simple way, racking is nothing but the mounting apparatus for the solar array. All of you understand that? What is the racking system? So another one, other components are also there. along with the four main components. So other components are must to be batteries. So in the figure I have shown you which are the extra components. So let's see which are the extra components. I will show you one figure. So this figure, which are the extra components? Solar panel we have seen, inverter we have seen, network meter, then electric meter, grids, then line, distribution lines are also there, batteries are also there, then safety valves or safety timing are there. So that all components are the other components which are working for the efficient working of the photovoltaic system. So I think all of you understand how does that photovoltaic system will works and which are the components of the photovoltaic system. So next point we will continue in the next lecture. So you have to watch the next lecture for the next point.